Open source software is the backbone of the entire software development industry. But while we admire those great, shiny, VC-backed startups with fancy websites, the impact of open source software is often overlooked. So in this new series, we're putting things upside down and try to get open source software just a little bit closer to the recognition that they actually deserve. In redesigning open source, I'll take open source websites, which a lot of the times have not been updated in many, many years, and turn them into something that looks a lot more like a website designed in the year 2024. Starting with FFmpeg. FFmpeg is one of those projects that often goes unnoticed, but is actually used a lot in media companies and software products under the hood. For those of you who do not know FFmpeg, it is primarily a command line interface that can be used to perform all sorts of manipulations to video and audio data. For example, it makes it really easy to convert a video from one format to another, or compress it so that you can save up space on your disk. But FFmpeg can do a lot more than just simple tasks. It's also known for its immense configurability and compatibility with basically any format and codec that you can think of. For the redesigned FFmpeg landing page, we'll create 5 new sections. A hero section to explain what the project is all about. A testimonial section to show who uses FFmpeg. A feature section to explain the most common use cases of FFmpeg. A section for installation instructions to make sure that you can install FFmpeg on every system that you can think of, and one section for advanced tools and libraries, for those who want to dig really deep and explore all the ways that you can use FFmpeg. Because this tool that was originally created by Fabrice Bellard in the year 2000 has a lot to offer. While FFmpeg has evolved a lot since then, and only a small fraction of today's code was actually written by Bellard, he laid the foundation of what has become one of the most impactful tools in audio and video processing in the modern age. Bellard himself, who by the way might be an actual genius, is not only known for creating this amazing command line tool, but also for discovering a faster algorithm to calculate single digits of pi, and also for creating QEMU, an open source emulator that allows you to run various guest operating systems on your machine. And those are only a few of the projects that he has worked on. Over the years, the FFmpeg website got quite a few updates, and it went from a very barebone HTML page with a Formula One style logo to a more familiar looking green styled website in 2009, with those iconic W3C validator badges. Until it received its last revamp in 2014, so about 10 years ago. And for that, the design actually holds up pretty well, but I think we can give it a little bit of a more modern look than that. So let's actually get going and start with the new hero section. For this, I made a slightly modified version of the current logo that combines the logo from around 2010 with a fresh gradient style similar to the current one. While I don't particularly like the 3D effect of the current logo, I really like the font, so I tried to find out which one it is. Turns out, nobody really knows. I started to dig up mailing lists from over 10 years ago, where people discussed the origin of the logo and that it was designed by a French graphic designer, who apparently never got back to them with the information about the typeface. So I gave up on finding the original one and just went with the next best Google font that I could find that was close enough to the original one. The current website highlights one of the most common examples of how to use FFmpeg right on the homepage, how to convert a file from one format to another. With FFmpeg, this is really easy because you can just provide the input file using the input parameter and choose the output format by providing the output file name with the format. And FFmpeg will automatically detect and convert basically any audio video format that you can throw on it. And while this only shows a very simple use case of FFmpeg, it is a perfect introduction for this Swiss Army knife for audio and video that can be used to transcode, compress, and edit basically any audio video file in the universe. With the hero section done, let's take a look at what amazing companies are using FFmpeg for our testimonial section. So, there are quite a few companies that we know use FFmpeg, and there's even a Wikipedia category collecting them. Among them is OBS, VLC, Blender, Google Chrome, and Audacity. But that's only the software where we know for a fact that they use FFmpeg, because at least parts of them are open source. And let me tell you, there are a lot more companies using FFmpeg. There are reports from YouTube, Facebook, and Netflix using FFmpeg at least at some point. And they probably use it for some use cases up to this day. But the nature of those closed source companies also makes it really hard to verify any of this. And even listing those companies won't do justice to just the impact that FFmpeg had on the entire video and audio ecosystem. So what I'll do instead is feature every damn media company on earth in the testimonial section. Because this just feels way more appropriate and should be convincing enough, so let's move on to the feature section. The one design element that can't be missing on any 2024 landing page is a bento grid. So let's use them to highlight the unique features of FFmpeg. First off, FFmpeg is open source. It is licensed under the LGPL and GPL license depending on what part you want to use. The GPL license is a copyleft license and therefore requires you to redistribute the source code of your software under the same license. While the LGPL is a little bit more relaxed than that, and for the most part allows you to only redistribute the parts of the software that were originally licensed under LGPL. Also, this is not legal advice. FFmpeg runs cross-platform, so you can install and use it on Linux, macOS and even Windows systems, and it's super fast in doing so. The CLI tool supports various hardware acceleration features and is written in C and assembly to provide the best performance possible. And probably one of the most important points, it's battle-tested by every damn media company on earth. But what can we actually do with it? To demonstrate the tool, let's pick three of the most common tasks FFmpeg is used for: compression, scaling, and editing. It surprises me every time how much space you can save by simply compressing the videos on your disk, and FFmpeg makes this incredibly easy. Just provide the input and output files like we've seen before, and define a codec with the vcodec parameter. This can just casually shrink down your files by 70 to 80%. And I don't know about you, but I suck at resource management and run out of disk space constantly. You can also easily scale up and down videos with one of FFmpeg's many provided filters using the VF parameter with the format that you want to scale the video into. This can be especially useful if you want to provide media files in different sizes and resolutions. But it doesn't stop there. You can even use FFmpeg as a simple video editor for cutting and trimming. Using parameters for the start and the stop timestamps, you can cut videos right from the command line interface really fast. And FFmpeg has so many more features, so I'm just gonna speedrun the rest of them. FFmpeg supports encoding into more than 200 codecs and can decode from over 500, which means that you can transcode even the most ancient video codecs that you have never even heard about into some standard format. FFmpeg also supports multiplexing, which means that you can combine an audio and video file into one file together, and also demultiplexing, which is the opposite, to split an audio and video file apart. You can also stream files to a multimedia server or a service like Twitch or YouTube. And do you remember those filters I talked about earlier for scaling the video? Well, you can do a lot more with them. You can change the contrast or the brightness, or you can even add subtitles to your video with them. And last but not least, you can simply record your screen right from the command line using FFmpeg. At this point, you might or might not be completely sold on FFmpeg. So how do you actually install it on your computer? FFmpeg provides packages and executables for basically every operating system in existence. On Linux and Mac, you can just use a packet manager like apt-get or brew to install the CLI tool. And of course, you can also just download the source code of FFmpeg and compile it for yourself. But FFmpeg is actually not the only CLI tool offered by the FFmpeg project. While FFmpeg is by far the most popular tool, mostly for converting, editing and recording audio and video, there's also FFplay, a command line tool which lets you play any of the supported audio and video files in a player, while allowing you to use all the features that FFmpeg provides. And there's also FFPro, which can be used to check all sorts of metadata and information about audio and video streams, like codecs or container formats. If you want to dig even deeper than that, FFmpeg also offers advanced libraries that you can use in your C programs. There's libav codec, the library used for encoding and decoding, libav format, which is used for multiplexing and demultiplexing, and libav filter, the powerful filter library used for adjustments of video and audio. But be aware that those libraries might not be as easy to use and the documentation might be a little spare. So let's add a nice footer with all of the links to the stuff that I wasn't able to include on the landing page, and the design is basically finished. All that is left to do is to convert it into an actual website. So let's set up a new Astro project and get some Tailwind action going, because that's just my preferred tech stack for landing pages right now. For the interactions in the feature section, I'm gonna drop in Alpine, which is a lightweight JavaScript framework which allows me to add small reactivity bits on an existing website. And to make the entire landing page look just a little bit more polished, let's add a few animations using Rive. It allows me to add different states that I can bind to my Alpine state and update the animation together with the UI state. And that's it, the landing page is done. If you're curious how long it took me to finish all of this, including this video, I'll have the stats on screen right now, tracked with Solid Time, an open source time tracker that I help building right now. So if you're looking for a time tracker for your freelance or agency work, you can check out Solid Time on solidtime.io. We just recently released our all new reporting features. And if you wanna see the redesigned landing page itself, you can head over to ffmpeg.bufferhead.com to see it in its full glory. Also, please keep in mind that I was neither contracted nor asked to do any of this work. I just did it because I think it's a nice way to show some appreciation for all the work that the maintainers put into this project. And I also think it's a really nice way to showcase some open source projects. That being said, if anyone from FFmpeg is watching this and wants to adapt any of the stuff that I just showed, feel free to reach out to me and I'm happy to help. The source code for this landing page is also on my GitHub profile. If you're still watching the video and you enjoyed it, please make sure to leave a like, as it shows me that you want to see more stuff like this. And while you're down there, make sure to subscribe to not miss the next open source redesign. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.